Tell you what, guys, I mean, Jobs Ohio, as we look back, it's always been very controversial from the very beginning. Questions about its first director, then court challenges, attacks from both the left and the right. Well, now the state auditor is calling on the governor to open the books.
Did someone instruct you not to answer our questions collectively?
Development Services Agency spokesman Todd Walker fended off questions from reporters Monday about government money and transparency. Walker's the former spokesman for the Department of Development, which Governor John Kasich replaced with Jobs Ohio. It was designed to be a private entity, but it's received over $5 million from taxpayers since its creation.
When in fact we're talking about government money being used for a government purpose by a corporation created by government, basically run by the governor of Ohio with board members that he appoints.
Maurice Thompson represents a Tea Party group that's suing Jobs Ohio on constitutional grounds. It's the very same view as Brian Rothenberg from Progress Ohio, a liberal think tank.
If it's public, it should be audited, it should be subject to public records, and there should be accountability in what they do.
Last week, Republican State Auditor Dave Yost fired a subpoena at Jobs Ohio's financial records, saying, quote, "It's important to look at the total picture. My job is to follow the dollars and facts and go where they lead, and that's what I'm going to do."
If you read the statute, it says this isn't public money.
House Speaker Bill Batchelder, also a Republican, disagrees with Yost. He says the audit's unnecessary because it's private money.
We're going to have to be in a position where we don't have some sort of an audit that questions whether funds were properly used by the Jobs Ohio group in order to attract someone to the state of Ohio.
Now, Batchelder dismisses those complaints about Jobs Ohio as just political. But we should point out again, Yost is a fellow Republican, and Jobs Ohio now has until March 19th to comply with his subpoena. Live in the studio, Jim Heath, 10TV News.